how many validators are active in this, you know, Frax Finance liquid staking solution? Currently over 1,000. It's a pretty good number here. Then on the right side here, you can see those, you know, growth graphs here. So starting from the November, you know, their stats itself is rapidly growing right now. It's pretty great. Hi, hello, I'm mr.masa. So today's an investment review for the Frax Finance token called FXS. Since I'm going to update the total score of the Frax Finance, so let's review it again. Then this is my portfolio strategy. So I only allocate my assets to the Bitcoin and all the altcoins which led to these seven categories on the right side. Then if you want to deepen your understanding about my portfolio strategy, please check out the video about my portfolio strategy. Then here's my video link. Okay. Then today's matching category for the Frax Finance is number 3, decentralized stablecoin. Then this time, they're going to newly add a new product, which is related to liquid staking solutions on L1 and L2. That is why number 6, BaaS and blockchain OS as a newly matching category here. Okay. Then as usual, I'm going to apply the 6 Anaka points to start from the pain points, products, team, execution power, token economy, and hype cycle. And for each, I set the 5.0 point here, so the total score is 30.30. Then if you want a deeper understanding about how I'm going to analyze each point here, please check out my video about my altcoin investment strategy. Then here's my video link. Okay. Then here is the score updates about the Frax Finance as of December 2022. So last time, my 2022 is 25.0 point. Then this time, December 2022, total score is 26.5 point. Then my minimum investing criteria is over 25 points. So from this perspective, I'm going to continuously recommend investment in Frax Finance token FXS. Okay. Then these remark area here, such as product, execution power, and hype cycle, I'm going to update the total score here. The other red mark area here, such as pain point, team, and token economy, there is no score change, but I have a critical updates about this project. Then from here, I'm going to tell you the detail. Yep. Then let's start here, pain point analysis. I have a critical updates about that pain point. And the first one, this one. So we need global decentralized stablecoin in post-US dollar era. Yep. Then all the time we're going to, you know, start from this slide about the decentralized stablecoin project. So market dominance of the US dollar, currently over 60%. It's amazing, right? But at the same time, this, you know, US dollar system has a pretty big problem here. Single point of failure. Because, you know, current our world currency system led by US dollar is just like a client server system. So centralized entity, which means US dollar, once they're going down because of the, you know, recessions or any kind of political trouble or something, other economy, you know, all over the world, get the huge damage for this. This is a single point of failure, right? So, you know, that is why we need to build a fully decentralized stablecoin project in the post-US dollar era, because by using blockchain technology, we can build much more distributed financial system, including stablecoin solution too, right? That's why we're gonna see the pretty big potential for this, you know, decentralized stablecoin project. Then to realize this goal, we may have two scenarios. It's actually only two scenarios. The first scenario, high potential cryptocurrency for decentralized internet. Then one of the high potential currency here, in my opinion, is Ethereum, ETH tokens. Some people say it's an ultrasound of money. Okay? But, you know, the problem here at this moment is price volatility, right? It's pretty highly volatile. So, you know, we cannot use, you know, those ETH tokens on our daily life. That is why we have to also suppose second scenario here. Scenario number 2, community currency basket systems die. A good example is, you know, MakerDAO system, but, you know, we also have other, you know, high potential decentralized stablecoin projects too, including Frax Finance. All right? The Frax Finance, their main focus in their, you know, early stage is actually scenario 2. They're going to start from decentralized stablecoin, Frax. But recently, they're going to pay attention to scenario number 1-2 by using liquid staking solutions. This is, you know, main topic we're going to dig into this time for the score updates about the Frax Finance, okay? Then, second point is closely related to this topic here, liquid staking solutions. So decentralized POS governance on Ethereum is the next big thing on its DAO. Why? Because of this. Look at this. So this data from Missouri, and then these are the major proof of staking player on the Ethereum DAO governance. Ethereum transformed their consensus algorithm from proof of work based one to proof of stake based one. That is why these major proof of stake validator on the Ethereum, you know, DAO governance model here is pretty important right now. Then potential issue we have to solve is actually there are two. First one is this one, red marketer here. Like Binance, Kraken, Coinbase, or the central entity. That's why we want to build much more DAO-based proof of stake validator on this ecosystem here, which is actually much more ideal. Think about the, you know, effectiveness of the, you know, DAO governance model by using blockchain technology, right? The second topic is this one. Look at the bull market here. Rido over 30.5%. The rocket pool is 1.61%. These player is DAO-based proof of stake validator on the Ethereum ecosystem. So they're pretty important for us. But the another issue we have to pay attention to here is Rido finance market share is too high. Over 32.5%. If the Rido finance, they're gonna take over 50% of proof of stake validator market share on Ethereum, Ethereum governance itself literally controlled by Rido finance. It's a big problem, right? Ethereum governance led by Ethereum DAO, not the other DAO governance. Okay? So from this perspective, you know, a lot of, you know, smart tech entrepreneur or, you know, early stage, you know, startups like, you know, Frax Finance, pay attention to the business opportunity here to let's build fully distributed Ethereum DAO governance by using liquid staking solutions here. Okay? Then number two, product analysis. So here's, you know, brief overview about, you know, their initial product, decentralized stablecoin, Frax. So their stablecoin is a kind of hybrid algorithmic stablecoin between MakerDAO DAI and also the USD Luna. Okay. So good example, like, you know, collateralization ratio. So as we know, the MakerDAO DAI is 100% backed for their collateralized model here. They can also apply their collateralization is actually pretty high, 150 to 300%. It's pretty high. So, you know, the Frax model here is around 85% is backed. Then also thinking about, you know, capital efficiency for the DeFi solutions, their collateral ratio is much lower, 100% to 135%, right? Almost half level of the MakerDAO DAI. All right. But also they're going to use some algorithm solution to stabilize, you know, their US dollar peg for the Frax token itself. From that perspective, they're going to also apply the technology with Luna. But the Luna, look at here, they used to only back by 7.5%. Then one of the reasons we're going to experience the Luna crash is because of this lower collateralization ratio. So Frax model is actually pretty well designed one with the hybrid model to achieve the capital efficiency. Therefore, the liquidity risk issue, they're going to also solve this problem by, you know, relatively higher collateralization ratio, around 85%. It's good. It's pretty good. Okay. Then another brief overview is about the, how they're going to mint, you know, Frax stablecoin. So when they're going to mint one Frax, you know, US dollar pegged decentralized stable currency, they're going to collateralize 0.5 FXS. Then also they're going to collateralize 0.5 USDC. So at least minimum level 0.5 USDC is fully backup. Actually, it's pretty much safe than USD by Luna, right? That's the things we can learn from here. Then those 0.5% FX is also gonna be burn, just like, you know, Luna USD, you know, burn mechanism itself. So, which from this perspective, FX token itself is deflation economy effects. More demand on the Frax, less supply on the FXS. Deflation economy effects on the FXS. This is also pretty well designed too. Okay. Then one of the key traction we have to pay attention to about the Frax is this one, Carpool TV updates. Look at this. SDEs, it's a liquid staking solution powered by Rhino Finance, but the other, like in Frax, or Carve Frax USDC here, all the Frax related pool. It's kind of huge success, right? Then this is also kind of key reason for me that why I'm going to so seriously pay attention to over the potential for leaky staking solution by Frax Finance. E's talking here. Why? Then from here, I'm gonna tell you the detail. Okay. So this is a leaky staking solution of Frax Finance for ETH tokens. They call it FRX ETH. Okay. Then solution is quite simple, similar to the right of finance. Once you're gonna hold your ETH token, you're gonna stake it, right? If you're gonna hold the same amount of ETH token, you're gonna stake it on the Frax Finance. Then you're gonna receive FRX ETH tokens. But from here, you have two options. Look at this, you know, this UI. So mint and stake or mint only. The mint and stake means it's a kind of passive liquidity staking. Then you're gonna receive SFRAX ETH tokens here with mint and staking. The mint only, it's a kind of active liquid staking. You're gonna make money on Frax ETH to ETH pool on Carb Finance. Then look at this one. So here also you can compare the APR. So about SFRAX ETH token, APR is 6.33%. It's already a product compounding solutions. All right. Frax ETH pool on Carb Finance APR is 10.57%. Because you know, business model here is pretty much different. SFRAX ETH model here, APR is 6.33%, is a compound liquid staking model. It's gonna be already applied to other like a competitor like Rocket Pool too, right? But you know, this Frax ETH pool is a liquidity mining business on the Carb pool. That is why APR is pretty much higher than liquid staking solution on this, you know, SFRAX ETH model here. Okay? Then, you know, let's compare with the other competitor here. So for example, Right of Finance, their major competitor, SD ETH token solution is liquid staking only. It's not a combining one, 6.4% APR. The Rocket Pool, RES, APR is purely, you know, liquid staking only is 3.83%, but plus POS node operations is 6.64%. It's a pretty good number here. Then also another new competitor, Swell. Swell ETH is 4% APR, and they also developed a new solution here by using, you know, some kind of NFT technology here with is SNFT. Then their APR is 6%, right? Then Frax, it's actually pretty amazing number here, right? It's pretty attractive for me. Then also we need to check out about, you know, how many validators are active in this, you know, Frax Finance liquid staking solution. Currently over 1,000. It's a pretty good number here. Then on the right side here, you can see those, you know, growth graphs here. So starting from the November, you know, their stats itself is rapidly growing right now. It's pretty great. Amazing. The other key topic we need to pay attention to is Frax ETH liquidity pool. Because Frax wants to keep ETH, BaaS, ETH to Frax ETH is 1-to-1, right? Then currently, Frax ETH is 50.9, then ETH is 49.1%. It's pretty well balanced one. This is also, I think, you know, one of a big expectation for like Frax ETH liquid staking solution, because they know how to run the business on a Carb ecosystem. That's why. Okay. This is kind of last item. So, you know, about the Frax ETH validator. Look at here, balance. Old player here, Frax Finance liquid staking solution is over 32 ETH is a minimum requirement to become Ethereum validator on POS. That's why. Okay. It's kind of good to know for us. Then number three, team analysis. So they are still pretty small team, but you know, they're doing quite well. So they kind of found it in June 2019. So relatively kind of middle-aged, you know, Web3 startups. And Sam, co-founder of Everypedia. And they most of the members coming from Everypedia. The Sam is a co-founder and CEO of Everypedia. Then Kaden, also from, you know, Everypedia. And Andy, also from Everypedia. Then Kaden, they get the neuroscience, BS with neuroscience at UCLA. And Jason also get the computer science at the UCLA. So it's pretty, you know, strong tech team here. Then plus five member, mainly USA. Then think about, you know, traditional level of the Frax and also like, you know, these like, you know, strong tech background. I have a pretty big expectation for the, you know, Frax ETH leaky staking solutions, okay? Then number four, execution power analysis. So first of all, we should check out their stablecoin key stats here. So we're going to compare Tether USDT, USDC, Binance USD, DAI, Frax, then currently Frax is ranked in top 5. It's great traction. The current market cap total circulation supply of the Frax stablecoin is over 1 billion. It's amazing. Then again, another key topic what I pay attention to is here, Cow Pool. Because SDEs is currently number one pool. Entire DEX on the ecosystem here, it's amazing. But look at the Frax. Once we're gonna summarize Frax and the Frax USDC pool here, it's already overwhelmed SD pool size here, right? Then that's another key point that we need to pay attention to, because Frax Finance made a huge success as a pool player on a curve ecosystem or curve or convex wall. If you are very familiar with these convex and curve ecosystem here, they have to very specialized knowledge and playbook to survive in curve and convex wall. The Frax made a huge success with this. Then leaky staking solutions, their main field will be curve finance. That's what I'm thinking about. So from this perspective, I have a pretty big expectation for them. They know how to win curve and convex wall. That's why. Again. Then once we look at the leaky staking TV updates here, currently Frax Ether is ranked in top 12. Then of course Rider Finance, it's a pretty big player here, but the look at the 7 days change on the Frax Finance, plus 40.80%. Amazing. And then 1 month change, plus 589%. It's great. Again. Then number five, token economy analysis. Then here, token economy design matrix, which I made. Then there are major matching category, decentralized stable coin and BaaS and blockchain OS. Okay. Then about network effects, I newly add here plus Frax is here. Okay. Then as we know, the Frax already apply deflationary economy effects of FXS tokens, which is a governance token of Frax Finance, right? So more demand of Frax, more deflationary economy effects of FXS tokens. So my big expectation for their next step here is once they can apply Frax ETH token economies with the binding mechanism of FXS token here, it's a pretty powerful, growth engine about the network effect model here. More buying power of FX tokens here. Okay, this is my big expectation for them for their next step. Okay, then here's benchmark analysis as of December 2022. So currently their market cap is 410 million. MakerDAO, their primary benchmark is 542. But MakerDAO only working on decentralized stable coin. So once Frax Finance get the pretty big market share on leaky staking solution on Ethereum, I think Frax Finance market cap overwhelm MakerDAO. It's pretty natural, right? Then about governance DAO, very active. It's great. And also, I love the transparency of Frax Finance. They've shared all the transaction data on their product here. That's great, actually. It's pretty amazing. I love them. Okay. Then number six, hype cycle analysis. So here, got the hype cycle analysis, blockchain Web3 hype cycle 2022 versions. Then their major matching category, blockchain wallets, blockchain platform, because they're going to start liquid staking solutions. Then DeFi, stablecoin, Web3, and DAO. Then DeFi, stablecoin, Web3, DAO, all pretty hot topic all the time. So, all the time, Frax Finance get the pretty strong market momentum here. Especially leaky staking is the next big thing on the Ethereum ecosystem. So this is also, great advantage for them from the momentum perspective. Okay. Then final item, total score. So they're about pain point, no change. But I newly added the one pain point here about the leaky staking solutions. Okay. Then product, I upgrade from 4.0 to 4.5 simply because you're going to add it the leaky staking solutions. This is the biggest topic on the Ethereum governance here. And also, they know how to play on a convex wall. So they're going to make, you know, much more competitive product compared with other alternative liquid staking solution providers such as Rider Finance or Rocket Pool. That's why I set the 4.5 here. Team level 4.0. No big change here about the team profile here, all right? But, you know, they are pretty strong at the tech. This is great. They already used to work together at the Everypedia, so that is why they have a pretty good teamwork here. So 4.0. The execution power, I'm going to upgrade from 4.0 to 4.5. You know, look at the trash of the Frax. You know, stablecoin project. It's amazing success. So I have also big expectation for their liquid staking solution too. Their product itself is pretty well designed. Very competitive one. So I set the 4.5 here. Token economy, 4.0. So once they're going to integrate deflation economy effects of the Frax ETH token, it's very, very competitive one. But that is why I set the 4.0 here still. Okay. Hive cycle, I'm going to update from 4.0 to 4.5. It's because, you know, these days DeFi get the pretty strong market momentum. And they're like, you know, Frax stablecoin pool, also liquid staking solution, it's very resilient solutions on a, you know, the bear trend on the crypto asset market. So they can attract a lot of, you know, institutional investor from the traditional financial market to this new financial market here. That is why they can get a pretty strong market momentum. So I set the 4.5 here. So the total score is 26.5 points. So my minimum investment criteria is over 25 points. So from this perspective, I'm going to recommend an investment in Frax Finance Token FXS. Okay. Then if you're interested, much more detailed information about my portfolio allocations and also my real-time buy and selling signal for every single crypto assets, including ICO, ID on DeFi, please think about to join my premium membership program, real-time buy and selling signal. The major purpose of this membership program to help to reach your crypto asset performance to my level here. Then for more detail, please check out my video. Then here's my video link. Alright, so that is all this time. So I'm going to make this video for educational purpose. So I'm not going to guarantee you any kind of certain level investment outcome with this video or in this video that I make. But I truly hope that my video probably help you guys understand about high potential about crypto and virtual space. So I'm going to make a lot of in this video crypto and virtual space. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Bye bye.